Today in this lecture, we'll be doing applications of marginal costing. Marginal costing or CVP analysis, it is very, very important for decision making. In daily life, businessmen have to take number of decisions and marginal costing applications facilitates taking such decisions. So the various decisions which are taken are profit planning, make or buy, cost in different point, key factor, sales mix, acceptance of offer order, dropping of a product, capacity utilization, handling different alternatives, introduction of new products. Today in this lecture, we'll be covering two applications, that is profit planning and key factor. Before we discuss these two areas, I would like to revise some of the formulae being used in this analysis. So these are sales minus variable cost is equal to contribution, which is again equal to fixed cost plus profit. So this is also known as marginal cost equation. Profit volume ratio, contribution upon sales into 100. So we can make out from the equation 1 that if contribution to sales is 30%, then it is obvious that variable to sales would be 70%. The next is break-even point. So it is a point where businessmen have no profit or loss. And if we are to calculate break-even point in units, so fixed cost is divided by contribution per unit, which is equal to sales minus variable cost per unit. But if break-even volume is to be calculated, in that case, fixed cost is divided by PV ratio, that is contribution upon sales into 100. Desired sales. Whenever businessmen want to earn desired profit, in that case, if we are to calculate number of units to be sold, then fixed cost plus desired profit upon contribution per unit. But if desired sales is to be calculated in amount, then fixed cost plus desired profit upon PV ratio. The next one is margin of safety. It is simply the difference between actual sales and break-even sales. Or it can be calculated as profit upon PV ratio. The first application which we are going to cover in this lecture is profit planning. You know that every businessman has the aim of maximizing the profit. So profit is a function of sales and cost, or sales minus cost is equal to profit. And in practical life, there are so many intervening factors which may change sales and cost pattern, and ultimately profit is changed. Now the decisions which are required to be taken regarding profit, it can be how we can maintain the existing profit or how we can have a desired profit from the business. So I would like to illustrate my point with the help of practical problem. So here comes a statement. Students, this is problem 1 or practical problem 1 question from your book. Statement is, Quality Products Limited manufactures and markets a single product. Following are the data. Materials 16 rupees per unit. Conversion cost, that is variable, 12 per unit. Dealer's margin 4. Selling price 40. Fixed cost rupees 5 lakhs. Present sales 90,000 units. Capacity utilization is 60%. There is acute competition. Extra efforts are necessary to sell. Suggestions have been made for increasing the sales. So two suggestions which are given are, number one, by reducing sales price by 5%, or second option is by increasing dealer's margin by 25% over the existing rate. Which of these two suggestions you would recommend if the company desires to maintain this present profit? Give reason. So in this question, what we are supposed to do? We are to find out existing profit. Then by exercising both the suggestions, we will see which one is better. So let's find out present profit first. So in order to calculate profit, we'll be taking total of marginal cost, that is material 16, conversion cost 12, dealer's margin 4, that makes total of 32 as the marginal cost. contribution per unit is selling price 40 and variable cost 32, and ultimately contribution per unit would be rupees 8. So the total contribution on 90,000 units would be 90,000 units into rupees 8, that is 7,20,000, and when we deduct fixed cost from this, that is 5 lakh, we'll be getting present profit of 2,20,000. So we need to maintain this amount of profit, or we can say we want to earn the same level of contribution, that is 7,20,000, as 5 lakh fixed cost would remain same. So this is the reason why in marginal costing we ignore fixed cost, because it is a period cost and it doesn't change in the coming period, coming future time period. So it doesn't play any role for the decision making. So taking suggestion 1, reducing sales price by 5%. So definitely the new sale price would be 40 minus 5% of 40, it is coming out to be 38. New dealer's margin at the rate of 10% of selling price, that is 3.8. Now the question arises, this 10% rate is not given in the question. So why we are taking this rate here? Actually, the initial selling price is rupees 40 and the dealer's margin is rupees 4. So it is obvious that it is a variable expense which depends upon sales, and it is 4 rupees out of 40, it is a 10% of sales, and the same rate has been applied here. Now sales required to maintain present profit of rupees 2,20,000, again we will have to calculate contribution, new contribution per unit with reduced selling price of 38. So new variable cost or marginal cost would be, material is 16, conversion cost 12, dealer's margin 3.8, that makes total of 31.80, and ultimately new contribution per unit is 6.20. Now in order to find out number of units to be sold to earn given profit of 2,20,000, we have to divide total contribution required, that is 7,20,000, by new contribution per unit, that is 6.20, and ultimately we are getting 1,16,129 units required to be sold to earn profit of 2,20,000. Next we will be analyzing suggestion B. So suggestion B is increasing dealer's margin by 25%. So the present rate of dealer's margin is 10% of sales plus 25% increase, it would be 2.5% hike, and new rate of dealer's margin would be 12.5%. Therefore new dealer's margin is coming out to rupees 5, that is 12.5% of rupees 40, that is the existing selling price. In this case there is no change in the selling price. So from this situation, again we'll be calculating contribution per unit. Variable cost, material 16, conversion cost 12, dealer's margin 5, that makes total of variable cost of 33 rupees, and contribution per unit is 7. Now sales required to earn same amount of profit, that is 7,20,000 units, it would be calculated by dividing total contribution by contribution per unit, in this case that is rupees 7, and ultimately we are getting the sale of units, that is 1,02,850,000. Now from the analysis given, we have to compare two things. First is contribution per unit, as it is higher in case of suggestion B. Secondly, the number of units required in order to make the same level of profit. So lesser the number of units required would give us the profits, better profits. So in option 2, the number of units required to sell are comparatively lesser, so we will be going with suggestion 2. So this is how marginal costing or CVP analysis help us to plan our profits. Now the next aspect which we are going to cover, it is key factor approach. Before we do this analysis, let's understand the meaning of key factor itself. Key factor is a factor or factor of production which is critical, very, very important, or which determines the rest of the operations of the business. So it can be material or availability of material, or labor hours, given labor hours, or production in units, or sales in units. So nowadays in the lockdown period, we can see or we can understand that we cannot very easily make out sales in the market. So sales is a critical factor. It would determine the production operations and the arrangement of rest of the inputs. Means if we cannot sell in the market, so there's hardly any use of making other arrangements. Now we'll see how it works with the help of again practical problem. It is again from your book, practical problem number 14. Two products are manufactured in a factory. The prime cost, variable overhead cost, and the selling price per unit are given below. So the comparison of two products is given, product A and product B. Again, direct material 100, 150, direct wages 200, 300, direct labor hours 60, 120, variable overheads 2000, 2500, selling price 10,000 and 12,000. The budgeted fixed charges for the year amounted to rupees 50 lakhs and budgeted direct labor hours are 50,000 hours. Now, we can understand that fixed charges that remain same as it is the period cost, but direct labor hours are never same. But in this question, we have a limit of making use of 50,000 direct labor hours. So we cannot exceed the limit. So this is the key factor in this question. Calculate the profit per unit of A and B if fixed charges are absorbed on direct labor hour method. Also state on which product the company should concentrate to get maximum profit, assuming there is unrestricted supply of labor and unlimited sales potential. Support your recommendation by calculations. Now let's understand what we are supposed to do in this question. Again, we'll be calculating contribution per unit. Higher the contribution, it would be better for the organization. So after calculating contribution per unit, we are to find out contribution per unit of critical factor or the key factor. So that would guide us to take decision regarding the production of product A or B. So let's see how it works. Fixed overheads are given 50 lakhs, budgeted direct labor hours are 50,000. Absorption rate per hour is calculated, that is 100, by dividing 50 lakhs of fixed overheads by 50,000 of direct labor hours. So we are supposed to make the statement of profit for both the products, product A and product B. So data is per unit given, and again we'll be finding out first of all marginal cost by adding all the variable expenses. Material 100, 150. Direct wages 200, 300, variable overheads 2000, 2500, and the total marginal cost is 2300 and 2950. And the selling price given in the question is 10,000 and 12,000. So contribution, when we deduct marginal cost from selling price, it is coming out to be 7700 in case of product A and 9050 in case of product B. So when we deduct fixed expenses from the contribution, we'll be getting profit or loss. So you need to understand here that in question, number of hours given for the production of product A is 60 and the absorption overhead rate is 100. So fixed expenses which are required to be spent for product A is 6,000. Similarly, 120 hours in 200. 12,000 rupees is in case of product B. So this would make the difference to the solution. So after deducting fixed expenses from the contribution, in first case we are getting profit of 1700, and in case of product B we are getting loss of 2950. Now you can see that contribution in case of B is higher than the contribution in product A, but still we are getting profit in case of product A and loss in case of product B. This is because of the number of direct labor hours required are double than the production of product A. Now next we'll be calculating PV ratio, that is dividing contribution by selling price, and it is 77% in case of product A, and it is coming out to be 75.4 in case of product B. And direct labor hours given 60 in case of product A and 120 in product B. So contribution per labor hours, contribution divided by labor hours, we are getting 128.33 in case of product A, and 9050 divided by 120 labor hours in case of product B, we are getting 75.42. So from these calculations, we see that PV ratio is higher, that is 77% as compared to 75.4 in case of product B. So A is preferred. So this is one reason. Secondly, contribution per labor hour, again it is higher in case of product A as compared to product B. So this is the another reason which would prove the role of key factor in business decisions. So this was all about these two applications. Hope you have understood the topic and keep revising. Thank you very much.